ne mai rangi puhi rā te unua.
Kia ora, I'm Zakara.
Ko Manu Walters, tōku ingoa.
Ko Christine, tōku ingoa.
Ko Te Aorangi, ko Whai, Pene Tito Morini, tōku ingoa.
My name is Destiny Korewha.
Ko Te Hohua Kora, tōku ingoa.
For rangatahi Māori, so young, to get it, to get that it's important to understand yourself and to teach us that is definitely changed my life.
I started the Kindness Institute maybe 6 or 7 years ago. And before that, I had kind of danced around with yoga and meditation, but just thought it was bullshit and didn't really get into it until I was living in the Dominican Republic. And we had the earthquake in Haiti in 2010. So I started getting into yoga as a way to take care of myself, and then started sharing it with our kids that I was working with over there, and they loved it. I couldn't believe it. So that's kind of where it started. And then when I moved back to Aotearoa, I was working with the rangatahi here who'd been kicked out of school, and we started a Māori tau and yoga program, and I couldn't believe how much they loved it and wanted it. And that's, yeah, where it all began. This youth mental health crisis we have in Aotearoa, like, that was a big drive as well, because I don't think there's enough being done. There's definitely not enough being done to support our rangatahi. And I think we've found a kaupapa that works.
My siblings are all girls. I was born the only male. When I was young, I was disconnected of to who I was. I knew I was Māori. But I didn't know which role to take until I came to Auckland and would never perform kabaka. I just felt uncomfortable. At school, I would always perform kabaka with my friends at lunchtime. And one of my teachers noticed that I would always perform like feminine as a girl. And one day she came up to me and asked, you know, what do you want? And I didn't ask myself that. So hearing it from someone else was, it felt good. My white world wasn't in line with my tina. And I thank my teacher today for that. And then one day, I went with that teacher to my kabaka tutor, and I asked her if I could perform as a waini on stage. And the tutor she was like, oh, come on, we've been waiting for you this whole time. And I was like, oh, wow. I didn't realise how, you know, everyone else understood me, but I didn't understand myself. So when she said yes, I was like, yay. But I think so when I asked her, we had to tell the principal and then, you know, we had to let the whole school know. And everyone was on board. Everyone, you know, were like, oh, yeah. But I think that's where I struggled most with communicating with my family.
Always been proud of Watsi. And I always looked up to her, even though she might not have known. I always did. And I think in some Māori whānau, there are people who are like, there's only male, female, that's it. But we have people like Watsi who are changing the world. And that's really cool. Really cool. And yeah, I'm just really proud of Watsi.
Yeah, I think Mirav would always know. I think she always knew when I was younger. I think she was my partner in crime. I'd be like, guys, steal me that skirt. And then we'd like walk around the house singing songs in my mum's high heels. And she was like, you're gonna fall over. I was like, I don't care. But yeah, I think you've always known.
And just to kick it off, we'll do a few deep breaths to connect to Te Ha.
When I was in uni, I was always feeling really alone, and like I didn't think anyone else was feeling the same way as me as well. I had my first panic attack, and in that moment, if you've ever had one, you know, you actually feel like you're dying, like you can't breathe and you start hyperventilating, and it's like you can't get that really nice deep breath. So learning about Te Ha helped me have a deeper understanding of like what it means to breathe. When you work through these tools, it might not feel good every time, but it's the fact that you're practicing it is the most important thing.
Moving towards the heels, kapai. Extending the arms long, releasing the forehead to papatuanuku.
How would you describe yoga?
Thought it was a load of shit. Like, I don't know. Like, yeah, you don't think it's for Polynesian people, you don't think it's for, yeah, it's not. And like when you're a teenager, you're like, that's not for me.
Yeah.
You're like, I belong on technology, but it's like,
shit.
Yeah. You know, when you first start, it's like, this isn't working because people expect a result within, as soon as you start it. But with this, it's like, it takes time and like all you have is time.
Release.
School is like it helps you in a way, but it's also like, yeah, there's all these challenges that no one like gives you advice on or teaches you, and there's nobody there to help you. And it's like, I can't help myself because I'm stuck. I need someone to help me. And I feel like a lot of people go through that and they don't talk about it. Like I remember getting bullied in primary school, and it was for my weight. Because I wasn't exactly, you know, the skinniest child, or like, I didn't know, like, there was a body standard, like, there's a beauty standard. I wish they knew how much their words affected people. It may just be like words, but they stick, like glue. And then like, because of how young I was, it stuck with me until I grew up. Like, I remember being little and I like, some days, because they called me that, I couldn't look in the mirror. And I guess like, that's the reality for some people. They don't realize what it does. It's like, people see my hair color and they're like, your parents let you dye your hair? I was like, it's a way for me to express myself. You should be allowed to do that too. There's no, it's your body. You know, they shouldn't have to be like, no, that's too revealing. Or like, if you feel good in it, you feel good in it. You
own it. Yeah. That's you. Don't let somebody tell you different.
Yeah.
What did you just call me out the gates? Oh my far out.
Inaya nei aroa kia whanga mea erongo nei o taringa.
Meditation is a really amazing tool to have. You know, especially if you have anxiety, I think that learning just a simple meditation that you can do when that's kicking off, because you always have that tool, you're always there with yourself, you always have your breath, so you have these things that can just hold you during those times, and I think that's really, really life-changing.
Before I kind of knew about it and had the tools, I used to spend a lot of the time being anxious about stuff that was coming up, and taught me how to just get over shit, you know, and just forgive yourself, you know, and instead of trying to get over stuff and like push it to the side, more like accept it and just deal with it and just, you know, laugh with yourself. So I was saying, like, ata whakarongo was like, you know, sorry. And yeah, and I think in life, you know, we're just constantly moving. We only use hikoi as a means basically to get from A to B, you know, because we've got somewhere to go. So we're just like, hi, you know, just trying to get past. So mindful walking is perfect just to slow everything down and just basically use it to meditate at the same time. Two manus with one stone. No talking or interactions, we're just gonna hono to ourselves.
I think having a voice, it makes you feel valid, like all the examples here. It makes you feel good, it makes you feel heard.
It's like, even though it might feel weird for you to reflect back what someone said to you, like, oh, did you, so you want me to clean my room and do the dishes before lunchtime, is that right? Mm. Like, that might feel weird, but to that person,
yeah,
it feels so amazing to be heard.
When my uncle passed away, I felt like he took kind of like a piece of me with him. So I felt lost, and I'd turn my sadness into anger, and I'll go to school and put it into others. And then we had a hui about it, and then my mum came. When the teachers asked me why I was troubled, it was hard for me to say because my mum was there. But my mum was like the one who was aki-akiing me, like whakakipakipa I aho, to say what it was. Yeah, I said why, and my teacher understood, and my teacher like shed a few tears as well. And so did my mum. So we kind of felt the same hononga. I kind of know when he's around. Yeah, I can just feel it. Even though he's not here physically, he's still here, our wairua. One of my favourite things to do is to go out with my family. Like, I really love my family. Like, doing things as a family is my happy place.
He ririki tō tatu o. Because of that difference, we're not a people that live together anymore. The brother and the sister live that side of town or outside of town. We've lost, in a way, our connectiveness. That, to me, is a big breakdown in our tikanga. To understand whakapapa is to realise and acknowledge the source of that whakapapa and how that impacts or motivates those of that particular whakapapa, or how that motivates or impacts on you as an individual. Follow the process. Let your wairua take you through. Trust in your tikanga, and that'll help us through. Ko te pōkaitanga mai o te wānanga pea tēnei e kōrero hiana, kei te hoki kaha mai ngā ari a Māori. Kei te hoki kaha mai ngā wānanga e Māori ai tātou. A taihoa ke nei pau nei te 19 tau, ka tai ki tōna taumata, ka whakamanahia te ao Māori nā runga tonu i tōna kaha, ki te whakarewa i enei wānanga māramatanga mōhiohio, ka eke kapi ki karewa, ka maiangi. A marama te kite, arā te kura huna, arā te tauira.
Everyone's on their own journey. As long as we're still communicating, we can help each other.
Kei konei o tupuna ki tō taha, kei te tangi rātau, kei te menemene hoki ki a koe, kei te pai koe.
Everything will work out in time. Doesn't need to be perfect right now.
It's all right. You're safe. You're good enough.
No pain lasts forever.
You're not alone. I got you.
I hear you. I understand. And I'm with you. Thank you.